gives to you, and you just return that by being soft, right? Here, here, there, being soft. That's all. Not using a muscle. Yeah? But it doesn't mean your hand position changes. And so you can give here, or you can give like this. This is your full gift. This is just relaxing, finding her in your hands. Now, you want to do that on both sides. You want to get that contact even on both sides. So there, here. Yeah, take your contact. There she's bracing against you, so close your hips. That's her head. Just with that. And then she relaxes. You just soften her. That's what it is. And so she goes up a little and she's like, and then you close your hands. And if she softens, then you just give your hands. But it doesn't mean give does not mean throw it forward. But give is just a relaxing of your hands, of your muscles. Right? The contact stays the same in that sense. Right? So the distance between your hand and the mouth doesn't change. Yeah? You want to be a little more here with your elbow. Right? So now, if she starts moving forward, you will allow this here to move without your upper body moving. So your upper body is not moving forward, it's this here that's doing this. Yeah? So your elbow is like a shock absorber, and that is what basically gives you that stride, that space. And then that's quite a bit. You can see my hand moves about 5 inches at least, right? And so you don't have, it's not a ton, but you just basically slide back and forth alongside your body. If that walk starts really walking properly and she starts connecting to you and you start feeling like, hey, she's not just backed off and round, but she's starting to take contact and wanting to move her head a little bit, that's the freedom you kind of give. And the walk basically looks a little bit like that when you're walking. That's basically a normal walk. Good girl. Good girl. Yeah? Alright. Come on, we're changing direction. So in the walk, it works the exact same way. Now of course, if you close your hands, she'll slow down. So that's when we want to add leg. Sit on your seat bones. Relax your lower back. You can even there push a tiny little bit with your seat bone to say, hey, keep moving. But that's it. We overall, you stay fairly quiet. Now what we want to do, that's not bad, what we want to do is you want to add a little more hind leg to it. Good. And now you actually need to start following that a little because she needs that space. But if she, as you follow, just becomes longer, that's again when you have to say, no, whoa, 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 now, this is a little too much. Yeah, and you basically tell her that to a certain point, yes, cool, come out, but you know, just keep going. There. And then work on that neutral following again. And this will change every single time we change something, because her balance will change. So if we change, go to the trot, it'll change. If we turn, it'll change. Because she needs to learn to find her balance all the time, always. And you are part of giving her that balance.